welcome to a new episode by Flyboys Aviation. This episode is about the rise and fall of Sabena. Perhaps a name forgotten by some, it was, however, once the proud flag carrier of Belgium. What went wrong? And what does Swissair have to do with their demise? Let's take a look at this together. Sabena was founded in 1923. They started with flights to London and later expanded to other cities in Europe. Belgium, back then, had a huge colony in Africa, the Belgian Congo, about 76 times larger than Belgium itself. It actually started as the personal property of Belgian King Leopold. In a stroke of modest genius, he named the capital Leopoldville. Flights within the Congo also started in the late 20s. In the 30s, there was further European expansion as well as flights to the Congo. During the Second World War, European services were halted, but operations within the Belgian Congo remained. In the post-war years, they expanded their European operations and started transatlantic flights as well. For a short time in the late 50s, they even operated a helicopter service. The jet age arrived early at Sabena when they were the first mainland Europe airline to introduce the Boeing 707 in 1960. Caravels were added later as well. The Congolese decided they had had enough of their waffle-baking rulers during that time and declared independence. This meant the end of Sabena's dominance in the Central African aviation market. During the 70s, Sabena added the first wide-body airlines to their fleet, the McDonnell Douglas DC-10 and of course the Boeing 747. In the 1980s, Sabena started adding the first Airbus wide-body aircraft to their fleet. For almost all years of its long history, Sabena had been unprofitable. The Belgian government, being the main shareholder of the company, always injected capital in order for the carrier to stay afloat. In the early 90s, after the liberalization of the European airline industry and with the effects of the Gulf War apparent, the Belgian government realized Sabena needed a strong partner to survive. After some failed attempts with various European airlines, Swissair bought a 49.5% stake in the Belgian airline in 1995. This truly was the beginning of the end. Due to their supposed expertise, the Swiss were given carte blanche by the Belgian government to do with Sabena what they wanted, even though they didn't have a majority stake. Perhaps the Belgian politicians weren't very active in reading newspapers, because Swissair by that time was also starting to experience financial issues. In the years after that, it became apparent that Swissair used Sabena for their own gain. Contracts concerning orders, routes, catering, etc. that primarily benefited Swissair and not Sabena were signed. A prime example of this is the order for 34 Airbus aircraft that Sabena made in 1997. Sabena only needed 17, but Swissair convinced them to buy 34. They promised that they would provide funds for these additional aircraft. These funds, unfortunately, were never received by Sabena. In July of 2001, the Belgian government wanted to sue Swissair for not meeting contractual obligations. A deal was struck. The Belgian state would cancel their legal proceedings if in turn Sabena received 258 million Belgian francs from Swissair. Again, the Swiss failed to meet their promises. This, combined with the 9/11 attacks and the fact that Sabena was a chronically inefficient airline, caused them to cease operations in November 2001. What is the situation nowadays? Brussels Airlines can be seen as the successor to Sabena. They are not nearly as big as Sabena was in their heyday, but still, they did manage to make a small profit in 2017. They are wholly owned by Lufthansa. The same, by the way, goes for another European airline, Swiss. In the words of Alanis Morissette, isn't it ironic? Thanks so much for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. On my channel, you will find a new video every week that delves deeper into the fascinating world of aviation and offers you new insights. See you around. Thank you.